So much Giulietta. I think the SAS, the people are trying to sell them. I think they've seen the high prices in recent years, and maybe they thought that now it's time to sell. Who knows? So let's go and have a look, shall we?
And as always, there were plenty to look at. You could find an old wreck like this one. Lots of work for you. But in the end, you'll get yourself a 1900 coupe. There were cars from 3,000 euros to maybe 3 million euros that would catch my interest. And I'm quite sure you'll find your dream car also. Here's a body shell for one of those SASs. Almost finished. How about a little Fiat for competing in the Mille Miglia, original for you, sir? Our finished example like this one. Little engines. I love the Et Cetera from different coach builders, as they were found in obscure workshops and back alleys in many, many towns throughout Italy. And then there's this car, a 6C 1500, or I can't really see. I think it's a 1750 when you see the radiator. Made me wonder. I definitely think I saw this bodywork somewhere. And then it occurred to me. 7 years ago, when we followed the Mille Miglia, we made a stop at a little workshop on the borders of Toscana somewhere. And maybe they've sold it, but they definitely had this car as the family gem in their wonderful garage.
Look at that, in race trim. Just like Tatiano Volari would have driven it in the Mille Miglia back before 1930. With a riding mechanic, maybe Ramponi or somebody, who sit in that seat. Fantastic.
This is my grandfather.
That's your grandfather?
Yes.
And what year is this?
This is 33.
33?
Okay, let's get on with it. I think I've seen this car also somewhere, maybe in the Giulietta letter. It seems to have been running the Mille Miglia retrospective in recent years also. Wonderful blue color. And here in the privateer's tent, we have a 1600, a Giulia. And there's my friend Per Holmen. I was circulating at the Fiera with some of my Copenhagen fellow car enthusiasts, and it occurred to me they were Porsche fans. And believe me, this year there were Porsches all over the place. But I was thoroughly convinced about their enthusiasm when Jesper bought himself a Lancia. A Lancia Flavia 1969.
one, yeah. It's not new. No, no, but another one.
Yeah, another one.
Because it's not easy to find.
Definitely approved. Holding four grown-up men, we decided that maybe next year, after a stay over at Stefan's workplace, we would go four guys with cigars in this car. I'm also looking at Lancias. This is a six-cylinder Aurelia Berlina, 1952. Interesting. The suicide back doors and no B-pillar. Big style, but more than 50,000 euros.
How about that? That's a Berlina, right?
Approved.
Yes, what I'm looking for is of course a Flaminia Berlina. This is a late car from 1967 with the big engine. No wipers on the rear window, although curtains. And I think they've been trying to sell this car for a couple of years now. It's less expensive than the Aurelia. It has all the right mechanicals. So, maybe it's time to go to the bank. Or then, of course, how about a Series 1 Alfetta? This was a 1972 car. One of the very early examples. Or of course, the obvious, the Quattroporte. How stylish is that?
Laggiù nell'Arizona, terra di sogni di chimere, c'è una chitarra suona, e sulle boie panatere. Chi va a cercar fortuna, certo la troverà. Come una bimba bruna che poi la sposerà.
Quando mi guardi morire mi farai. Tanto mi piace, ma guarda gli occhi miei e forse capirai che bella cosa sei. Ti stringo forte a me e tu tremi, ti sento sospirare, t'abbandono così, senza parlare, chiedi un bacio ed io mi perdo in te. Che bella cosa sei. Quando mi parli.
We spent 2 days at the fair and the weather was perfect. It had been raining the days before, so we were kind of lucky, I suppose. Right, let me leave you with this car at the Roate Borani stand. They are always the most stylish at the whole fiera.
sei tutta per me. Qui sul tuo cuore non soffro più. Parlami.